When you first take a look at this right here, you might be thinking, this is definitely not correct. Well, you are not supposed to distribute the exponent like that, but don't worry, I will tell you. This right here is not an identity, meaning this is not true for all x values, but it's true for some x values, so we call this an equation. Now, I can tell you one x value right away, and that is x equals 0, because if you put 0 right here, we get 0 plus 2 and then raised to the 4th power. Is this 0 to the 4th power plus 2 to the 4th power? Sure thing, because this is just 2 to the 4th power, which is 16. And this doesn't matter, 2 to the 4th power, 16. So this right here definitely works. But unfortunately though, this is the only real solution. But don't worry though, because I will also show you guys how to find the complex solutions to this equation as well. So continue watching. First step is, we are going to multiply this out the right way. And to do so, I don't want to write down x plus 2, x plus 2, x plus 2, x plus 2. That takes too long. Don't worry, I'll show you guys a secret weapon. But if you're watching my videos, you know the secret weapon already, right? The Pascal's triangle, starting with 1, and then next you have 1, 1. And then you do 1, and then you do 1 plus 1, which is 2, and then 1. And then 1, 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 1 is 3, and then 1. One more. 1, and then 4, and then 3 plus 3 is 6, and then 4, and then 1. Stop right here. The first row is for the zeros power. If you have 0, you just get 1. The next one is the first power, and then second power, third power, and then the fourth power. That's what we want. These numbers are the coefficients of what we are going to do right now, and this is called the binomial theorem. Check this out. X plus 2 to the 4th power, starting with x raised up to the 4th power, that's the first term, and the coefficient is 1. 1x to the 4th power, and you can also put down 2 to the 0th power, but that's just 1, so it doesn't matter. Next, we just add. The next coefficient is 4, so put that down. And then you take x. The power of x goes down by 1, but you will have to introduce the 2, so it will be 2 to the 1st power. And then you continue with the same fashion. Plus, the next one is the coefficient 6, and then x. Power of x goes down by 1, but the power of 2 goes up by 1. So 2 to the 2nd, and they are all multiplying, of course. Continue, plus 4, and then x to the 1st, and then 2 to the 3rd, and finally, we have 1, x to a 0 doesn't matter, and then just 2 to the 4th power. So this right here will be the expansion for this. You can try it, just write it out, and then work it out, you get the following. Yeah, this. This. And of course, we still have the right hand side, which is x to the 4th power plus 2 to the 4th power. Here, let's just multiply things out and clean things up. Here we have x to the 4th plus 4 times 2 is 8, and then x to the 3rd. This is 4 times 6 is 24. X squared. This is 8 times 4 is 32. X. And then this right here is 16. And that is equal to x to the 4th plus 16. And as we can see, we have x to the 4th on both sides, so they are gone. Likewise, we can also reduce the 16 on both sides. So we're just looking for this being equal to 0. And now notice everybody has an x, so we can factor that out. And also, 8, 24, 32, they are all multiples of 8. So we can factor out an 8 as well. So 8x out, and then we will have just x squared. This divided by that, we get 3x, and then 32 divided by 8 is 4, and that's equal to 0. And unfortunately, this is not factorable anymore with real numbers. So let's just go ahead and put down the first part, 8x equal to 0, and then the next part, x squared plus 3x plus 4 to be 0. For this, divide both sides by 8, we get x equals 0. Done. And that's the only real solution that I told you guys earlier. For this, we have a quadratic equation, and let's just do it by the quadratic formula. Because the coefficient of x here is an R number, so completing a square, we will encounter fractions. So just use the quadratic formula. Here we go. X is equal to negative b plus or minus square root of b squared, so 3 squared, minus 4 times a and c. A is 1, c is 4. All over 2 times a, which is 1. And then for the inside here, let's see. 3 squared is 9, minus 4 times 1 times 4 is 16, and that is going to be negative 7. So the inside is negative 7. Then we get negative 3 plus or minus square root of negative 7 over 2. And because we end up with a negative number inside of the square root, so that's how we got a complex number. So this is equal to, let's write it as negative 3 plus or minus I square root of 7 over 2. And these two are the complex solutions for this equation.